When it was first developed in the early 20th century, the villa was known as the beauty of the Northwest Side, and you can still see it today on every block of this small neighborhood north of Addison Street. There are these great old stone pillars, beautiful boulevard parkways, and terrific arts and crafts houses, bungalows of various sizes all up and down the blocks. This one is one of the largest houses in the villa and the largest lot. The lots in the villa are 50 feet. This one is 100 or 101 feet. Beautiful house with the stucco lower and the siding upper. It's got a great arts and crafts feeling. You'll see when we go inside. And then it's got this expansive yard next door. We'll also, when we get upstairs, see that you can really look out over a lot of ground from the second floor. Let's go on in and see the whole thing. So you've got that whole arts and crafts progression from a semi-outdoor space, big front porch, in through a gorgeous foyer, a really welcoming place where the wood stairs, beautiful bench built under a leaded glass window, really make you feel welcome and tell you that you're inside. And then you come into this very large living room, probably once two rooms, opened up into a very large space with windows all around, especially here a big bay that takes advantage of that extra lot beside the house. And all around us there's this great original oak trim that really warms up the house, including this beautiful mantle, classic arts and crafts mantle over a wonderful brick fireplace. This to me is just sort of the quintessential villa amenity. Going on with that oak trim, we've got this beautiful old pocket door, interior windows, that opens to a nice big dining room. And it's got some of those classic features. It's got the beams on the ceiling, big windows for a view, and then nice built-ins in really great shape, still unpainted, really feeling like the natural wood that would have been put in originally. Behind the dining room is a kitchen. It's been updated. It probably was a bunch of little tiny rooms. Now it's a very large space. It's a modern kitchen, and it's an eat-in kitchen as well. Big space, and it goes off to a porch, an enclosed den, some other spaces. Then we should go upstairs to the second floor where the bedrooms, it probably was about six bedrooms originally. At least three were turned into the master suite. It's a real master suite, not something you usually find in a historical home. There's sitting room, bedroom, and then very large bath and walk-in closet. Each of those nodes probably was a bedroom kept separate. Two more big bedrooms on that floor. And then upstairs, there's an enormous space, now used as a single bedroom, could easily become two bedrooms, could be used as a family room. It's got a nice bit of light coming in from the highest windows in the house. You've got a family room up there if you want, but you also already have a smaller one in the basement. So there's an awful lot of space inside the house, but the way it really becomes an arts and crafts home is that it mixes with its outdoor setting via a whole bunch of porches. So then here off the rear of the second floor is this very large porch. We're sitting up nice and high, looking out over the trees, which are changing colors right now, so it's a great place to be. But this porch has two modes. We've got the open part I'm on here, and then behind me is the enclosed part, the screen porch. It wraps around the house. Might have been for sleeping once upon a time. Now they've got a table for dining. But you can sit up here and look out over your very large yard, not to mention all the spaces you've got arranged down below. Big deck that comes off the kitchen and works its way to the above ground pool. A smaller, more intimate terrace at ground level between the house and the alley garage. And then the very, very large lot that goes around two sides of the house. There's a fire pit and garden. That fire pit, by the way, is surrounded by bricks that may be original cobbles from State Street. And then all this garden space to the south of the house, which is very, very nicely landscaped. So you've got all these different spaces down there, up here. You might say you could enjoy this place on many different levels.